Huskies. Suyang got hit on the elbow, but still able to finish through that contact.
And a timeout called by Connecticut. 1:23 to go, second half. We've got a two-point game. I just love this time of year, Jimmy. It's cold outside. It's about 30 degrees, but nice and warm, ready for biggies. And Big Ten basketball on fire.
It's basketball season, baby. More importantly, it's conference season. This is where you cut your teeth, you make a name for yourself, you establish what kind of team you want to be. And if you're St. John's, down the stretch of this game, here's your moneymaker. Samson has four fouls. He can't be overly aggressive. You don't post up Suriyama right away, because you stop on the opposite side, or you involve him in the pick and roll where now he can roll to the basket, and then you feed him. Why? Because he's going to have space to work with. More importantly, it's going to be one-on-one on the post.
Each team with a timeout left. Both teams shooting in the double bonus. Here's a foul trouble. Soriano has got to be careful if he wants to stay on the court for this final. 1:23 of regulation.
I tell you what, also important, guys, guard play. If Sampson or Soriano are setting the screens, allow them to set. If they don't set, they end up getting called for a moving screen. So it's imperative that the guards are a second, a half a second late on coming off, just to ensure that if they're those two are involved in the pick and roll, that they won't pick up the cheap foul and be regulated to the bench.
So we see with the timeout left, Castle will throw it in bounds. Duke, Caravan, Samson Johnson, and Cam Spencer. 1:20 to go. Castle running the court. Just got it on the right wing, guarded by Dinkle. Handoff, Spencer, tend to shoot. Handoff, Duke curl, leaves his feet, picks it. Caravan, six to shoot. Duke, four to shoot. Spins, gets a bang off the glass, no. And the rebound goes to Spencer with a new shot clock, under a minute to go. 67-65. 8 to go on the shot clock. Duke takes a three. No. Rebound Latham. Will Rick Pitino call a timeout? He'll let him play. Down by two. Soriano wants it. They give it to him. Draws a double. Somebody's open. Soriano now drops down. Inside. Wrapped around. Latham at five. 10 on the shot clock. 17.7 on the game clock.
Because this is where experience pays off, because Soriano didn't panic when Cam Spencer came on the double team. He held it a second or two, forced Cam Spencer to go back, then went into his move, and then when the second double team came, he was able to drop it off inside to Ledlow.
Ledlow, a 75% free throw shooter. Ooh, he missed out on the back. 1-3 from the line for the Harvard transfer. And a timeout called by St. John's. They're now out of timeouts. Upcoming schedule for the Red Storm, Hofstra, and then back in the Big East play. Butler, Villanova, Providence, and Creighton. So, this timeout call, Letham misses the free throw. What is Rick Pitino saying to his team?
Well, it's two different things.
With 17.7 on the clock.
If you make it, you're down one. Miss it, you're still down two. If you miss it, if you make it, you want to force the ball to get into the corner, see if you can get a quick track. The first pass out of the track is when you foul. It's a little bit different when you miss the free throw, because your defense can't set it. You can't get the